Hey, oh. What's going on here?
Oh. Wait, whoa,
hold the phone.
Wait a minute.
And a director's chair.
Are you about to read us something?
No, I'm not going to read you something. So we wanted to be able to chat to some of our campmates and
find out some of the golden bits.
Yeah. So we thought, why not do our own podcast?
Jungle podcast.
Jungle podcast. So I don't know whether any of you know, but the traditional way I start a sentence is I was listening to a podcast. And we thought we might as well actually do a jungle version of a podcast. So we've called the podcast Highlights, Happiness and Ham.
Highlights, Happiness and Ham.
So the idea is you tell us some happy moments, some highlights of your life, and then your favourite ham-related experience. For our very first guest, we would like to welcome to the stage Emily Seebohm. Yay!
Emily Seebohm.
Hi.
Hi, and welcome to Highlights, Happiness and Ham.
So, Emily, you are an Olympian.
Oh, yes.
You've won 7 medals. What is the moment like at the Olympics when you receive your medal?
I remember Beijing the most. I remember it just, like, real clearly because I had so much fun. Like, I was on the team, so it was me doing backstroke, it was Liesl Jones doing the breaststroke, it was Jessica Shipper doing the butterfly and Libby Trickett doing the freestyle. So, like, these are some pretty big swimmers in my day. Like, they were huge. And I was freshly 16, so for me it was just unbelievable. And, you know, in the marshalling room we were kind of just, like, singing and, like, laughing and having fun. Like, it didn't really feel like it was such a big thing because we broke the world record as well as winning the gold medal.
Wow.
Like, I didn't realise how big that moment is because that moment was on stamps, like, it was in the paper, it was on TV, like, it was massive. And then, yeah, so we're singing the national anthem and we're, like, hand by hand, like, yeah, it was the one that I remember the most.
So you were 16, freshly turned 16, the youngest in the team, yeah?
Yeah, youngest.
So you're an Olympian medalist now, and after that, you went back to school?
Yeah, I went back to school.
Like, what's that like, going back?
Like, it wasn't weird for me because that was just my normal life. Like I think at one of my school meets, I was 0.02 off a world record.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
And, like, I didn't even know, but that's how I've been my entire career. I don't know. I barely know my best times. I barely know my medal stats. Like, I don't know at all. And I just remember the places and the people that I've met.
Emily's story was mind-blowing. I mean, I always knew she was a big name, but then her humility, she's just herself, and it's just, it's really refreshing.
I just have fun. Like, this is what I wanted to do my entire life.
And so apart from like, the Olympics, what's been a real highlight of your swimming career?
Before Rio 2016, I was going in world number one for both the 100 and the 200 backstroke. I had won the world championships the year before, so I was going in current world champion. I came sixth in the 100 back, so I blew out, like, majorly. Like, I was so far off my best. I didn't even make the final for the 200. Like, I... out of the world for all of them. And my proudest moment has been that I got out of that pool and I turned to the camera that was there. I stood up there and I said, that was just the best I could do today. And I didn't cry, I didn't blame anything. It was that's just the luck of the draw sometimes. Sometimes you just don't compete well. And that's been my proudest moment.
Because what a great message.
I stood true to myself.
That's it.
That's all I could do.
Because you're a role model, you know. So that kind of message for people hearing that is such a powerful, wonderful, empowering and excellent message. Well done.
Thank
well
you.
Done.
Good job, Em.
I can see why you're proud, mate. That's awesome.
Yeah. I love her mentality. I love her attitude. Yeah, she's a very mature young woman. And deserves all the success that she's been able to gain to this point.
Oh, we have to find out from you. What is your favourite ham-related moment?
look, I don't eat lots of ham.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Movie about pigs? Any movies about pigs?
Look, I loved Babe.
There it is.
Like, everyone loved Babe, right?
Yeah, of course.
Like, everyone wanted a little Babe.
Yeah.
But, yeah, that's about it.
Is that it?
Yeah, that's it.
Well, Emily Seebohm, thank you for joining us on the Highlights, Happiness and Ham. And, of course, to Emily!
Chatting with my old mate, Cal. It was lovely. We had a great time when we worked together. But, geez, it's been 12 years since we did that. And I know that because both our kids are 12. I loved it.
I like happiness and happiness.